What's up YouTube? Welcome to your 48th Java tutorial. And in this tutorial we're going to be going over instance variables with the final. Like when you have like public final or private final int. That's where we're going to be going over. So unlike static, I'm going to be showing you guys what final means. So let's go ahead and in your tuna class right here, and this is the one that's not your main. Apples has my main method. So go into another one. I name my tuna. You can name yours whatever you want as long as it's a fish. That's key. It has to be fish or this program won't work. I'm just kidding, but you know, just a little joke. And let's go ahead and the first thing we're going to want to do is make a variable that's going to be private as well. But you got to spell it right. That's key. Private. There we go. I know I'd get it eventually. Int sum. And what this is going to do is hold the sum of our numbers that we're about to add up. Now let's begin the tutorial. What we want to do now is make a variable with the type final. So private final, and it's going to be an integer variable. And I hit button there. Embarrassing. And let's just name it number or something. And go ahead and put it in caps because it's going to be a constant, so we know that the constants are in caps. K. There you go. K. That's how you can remember it. So now the key, or what final is whenever you write final in front of a variable or a constant, it means that you can't modify this no matter what. So we just declared it. Whenever we set it equal to something, whatever we set it equal to, we can only set it equal to it once. So if we put number equals 2, then that number is going to be 2 for the rest of your life. You can't change it no matter what. But another thing is we declared it right there, but we didn't initialize it, which means we didn't set it equal to anything. So we're going to have to do that in our constructor. So again, you can either do it right here or you're in your constructor. So let's go ahead and make a constructor. Put public tuna and just put int x. This is going to be a temporary variable. And then put number equal to x. So whatever we pass in for our argument, that's what number is going to be equal to. And again, don't mess it up because you can't change this. You can't later in your program write, alright, we're set it equal to 2 here, but we're going to set it equal to 15 later on, or 18, or 32. You can't. You can only set it equal to something here, and it stays like that forever. Now let's go ahead and build another method. So let's go ahead and write public void, make it called add, because what's it going to do? It's going to take that sum that we have up here, and it's going to be 0 default, and let's just add the number to it. So again, the sum variable is going to change, but this number is always going to be like 10, or whatever we say it is. And now let's just build one more method so we can actually see what's going on. Public string to string. So again, you learned what the toString method did last time. Whenever you need your object in a string format, it returns it. So let's go ahead and return string format. And it already started filling out for us. The format's just going to be put something like sum is equal to %d, and then put like a new line for good looks. And then for your arguments, just put sum. So this is going to change because it's the number that stays the same and not the sum. And how do we know that? Because number variable is final and sum is just private. Sum can change. So now that we got that, look it over and make sure it's the exact same as mine. We can go to our main class, which is apples in this case. So go ahead and let's create an object. Say tuna object equals new tuna, and let's go ahead and put something like 10. So now what this is going to do, since we passed in 10 to our constructor, it's going to take 10 for x, put 10 for x right here, and set number equal to 10. So now for this object, number equals 10 no matter what. We can't change that. So anytime we use number, like add number to sum, we add 10 to sum. Simple enough. So now let's go ahead and, well, let's go ahead and make a for loop using this object. So let's just put 4, and let's make a simple loop. Put like int I equals 0. If I is less than 5, and I plus plus. So it loops 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep, loops 5 times. It really doesn't matter what you have inside your for loop. This isn't important. Just had to make something real quick. Now we can go ahead and say, what do we want to do 5 times? Well, let's go ahead and add, let's call this method 5 times. So the first time, it's going to be 10 when it adds it. The second time, it's going to add another 10 to it, so it's going to be 20. Then it's going to be 30, 40, 50. Simple enough. So let's go ahead and add tuna object, and how you use it is add right there. So now we did our method 5 times, but we can't really see anything because this method right here, it doesn't return anything, so we need to return it right here. So let's go ahead and put system out. Let's go ahead and let's do a print format, and let's just go ahead for the format, we'll put something like, let's keep it simple, %s, and for the arguments, let's just go ahead and put tuna object. So let me go ahead and run through this and show you guys the results. Sum equals 10, sum equals 20, 30, 40, 50. So now let me talk to you guys one last time why this happened. Make sure, hopefully I'm in my screen recorder. And good enough. So what we did is we made 2 variables. Well, let's just go ahead and do it this way. We made an object called new tuna, or tuna object was the name of our object, and we passed it the parameters 10 for the constructor. So it took that 10 and set number equal to 10. Alright, simple enough. What's next? Well, we looped through this 5 times. So what did we do 5 times? We did this add method 5 times. So first, for add, it took that number 10 and added it to sum. So now sum was equal to 10. Then it just spit out 10. And then the next time, on round number 2, it took that 10 and added it to 10. Then we got 20. So now it spit it out 20. Then it took 10 and added it to 20, which was 30. Then it added it to 30, which was 40. Then it added it to 40, which was 50. Now that that's all done. So that is pretty much your really detailed tutorial on a really simple explanation that whenever you make a final variable, you cannot change it. So for example, if we say down here, tuna object dot number equals 15. Look at this right here. We get an X right here. The field tuna number is not visible. That means that it can't change pretty much. So that's pretty much all in all. I could have skipped this whole tutorial and said, alright, when you write final instead of a variable, it means you can't change it, but I didn't. I decided to give you guys the whole spiel instead. So thank you guys for watching, and hey, if anyone wants to do fantasy football with me, leave a comment and let me know, because I want to do fantasy football with someone. So thank you guys for watching, and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.